Steve Patterson here from Photoshop Essentials. In this video, we'll look at two new features for the Remove tool in Photoshop 2024 that make it easier than ever to remove people, objects, or distractions from your photos using the power of AI. I'll zoom in on this image that I downloaded from Adobe Stock, and I'll use the Remove tool to remove the chair, the bag, and the shadow, and replace them with new AI-generated content. So the Remove tool is still found in the toolbar nested in with the Spot Healing Brush and Photoshop's other healing tools. And in the Options bar, we find two of the same options from Photoshop 2023. Sample All Layers lets you work on a separate layer so you can remove objects non-destructively, and Remove After Each Stroke will remove the object you painted over as soon as you release your mouse button. What's new are these two options on the left: Add to Brushed Area and Subtract from Brushed Area. Add to Brushed Area is turned on by default so we can paint over objects to highlight them. But we can also subtract areas we may have painted over by mistake before Photoshop removed them. And we'll see how that works in a moment. Now, whenever you're removing something from your photo, it's a good idea to work on a separate layer so you're not making permanent changes to the image. So I'll click the Add New Layer icon in the Layers panel to add a new blank layer above the background layer. But for this to work, we also need to turn on Sample All Layers in the Options bar. And I'll use the right bracket key on my keyboard to make my brush a bit larger. Back in Photoshop 2023, we needed to paint with the Remove tool over the entire object we wanted to remove. And depending on the size and shape of the object, it could take some time. And then when you released your mouse button, Photoshop removed everything you painted over and replaced it with AI-generated content. But now in Photoshop 2024, we don't need to paint over the entire object. We can just paint an outline around it. And Photoshop will highlight everything inside the outline when you release your mouse button. And then after a few seconds, the highlighted objects are removed. Now, even though the Remove tool does use AI, it's not as powerful as Generative Fill, and it sometimes leaves artifacts or repeating textures. Here we see an obvious problem with repeating details in the sand, but you can just paint back over those areas with the Remove tool to clean them up. I've found that you get better results using a smaller brush, so I'll use the left bracket key on my keyboard to make the brush smaller. And it also helps to paint with shorter strokes to clean up smaller areas at a time. Another problem with the Remove tool is that it can create some blurry textures. But again, you can just paint back over those areas to fix them. I'll grab that artifact in the water and maybe clean up some of those blurry areas as well. If you paint over something and it still didn't fix it, you can press Ctrl-Z or Command-Z on a Mac to undo it, and then try again. And because we're working on a separate layer, the objects were removed non-destructively. If I toggle the layer off, the objects are still there. And if I want to remove them again, I just need to turn the layer back on. I'm going to delete that layer and start over, so we can look at the second new feature for the Remove tool, and that's the new Subtract mode. I'll make my brush larger again by pressing the right bracket key on my keyboard. Back in Photoshop 2023, one frustrating issue with the Remove tool was that if you painted over something by mistake, like her feet and part of the chair, well, there was no way to subtract it from the highlighted area before Photoshop went ahead and removed it. So you would need to undo it and start again. But now in 2024, we have a new Subtract from Brushed Area option in the Options bar. Now, it only works if you turn off Remove After Each Stroke. Otherwise, you won't have time to subtract anything. So I'll paint another outline, and again, I'll include her feet and part of the chair. And notice that the Subtract from Brushed Area option is now available. But I don't recommend choosing it from here in the Options bar because it will remain selected until you choose Add to Brushed Area again. A better way is to switch to subtract mode temporarily by holding down the Alt key on your keyboard or the Option key on a Mac, and you'll see the plus sign in the center of the brush cursor change to a minus sign, and then just paint back over those areas to subtract them. And if you subtract too much, release the Alt or Option key and paint over areas to add them back. And while I'm here, I'll subtract some of the areas within my chair selection where the sand and the water are showing through, just to keep as much of the original detail as possible. And because the Remove After Each Stroke option is turned off, Photoshop waits to remove the objects until we click the check mark in the options bar. And there we have it. That's how to use the Remove tool and its two new features in Photoshop 2024. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to my channel to learn more about Photoshop. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. I'm Steve Patterson from Photoshop Essentials.